an acme of pirate men as para pirate
men.
No, not friend.
Gello,
eh?
يقول اضغط عندك يلا يلا
قاعدني ضغط
Anatomy of thyroid and parathyroid gland. So about the thyroid gland is the largest endocrine gland, and where the thyroid gland is located. It is located in the midline in front of neck, in front of
lower body.
In front of trachea. And what is the shape and what is the weight? Weight is about 20 gram, and shape is butterfly shape, and thyroid gland is enclosed in pre-tracheal fascia. Besides its two capsules, it is enclosed in two capsules, and it is enclosed in pre-tracheal fascia, that is part of the
deep
cervical. There are four parts of deep fascia of the neck. One is pre-tracheal fascia. What are the parts of thyroid gland? Thyroid gland has got in the middle isthmus and two lobes, right lobe and left lobe. You can see in the diagram, the right lobe, left lobe, and in the middle, joining the two lobes is isthmus. Isthmus is lobes are lying on sides of trachea and larynx, and isthmus is lying in front of second, third, and fourth tracheal rings. About the lobes, each lobe is pear-shaped. It has got two poles, upper pole and lower pole, and three surfaces are lateral surface, medial surface, and posterior surface. If you see the poles, the upper pole extends to the oblique line of thyroid cartilage, and lower pole extends to the sixth ring of trachea. There are three surfaces: lateral surface, medial surface, and posterior surface. Lateral surface is overlapped by infrahyoid muscles that are sternohyoid and sternothyroid. It is also overlapped by sternocleidomastoid muscle. And medial surface is related to lower trachea, upper larynx, lower esophagus, and lower pharynx, upper esophagus, and in the groove between the trachea and esophagus, there are two nerves, that is recurrent laryngeal nerve and external laryngeal nerve. So the posterior and the medial surface is related to these structures:
larynx,
trachea, pharynx, esophagus, recurrent laryngeal nerve and external laryngeal nerve. These are the medial relations of the lobe of the thyroid gland, and posterior surface of the thyroid lobe is related to the carotid sheath. And what is carotid sheath? Carotid sheath is one part of the deep fascia of the neck. It extends from skull base. It is attached upwards on the margins of the carotid canal at the base of the skull, and lower down it is attached to the arch of aorta. Carotid sheath, so medial posterior surface is related to the carotid sheath and its contents. What are the contents of carotid sheath? Internal jugular vein and common carotid artery or internal carotid artery and vagus nerve. What is lying behind the carotid sheath? That is cervical sympathetic trunk. What is lying in the anterior wall of carotid sheath? Answer: cervical nerve. So posterior surface of the thyroid lobe is related to the carotid sheath and its contents.
Other side.
No. Yes. Now, these are the diagram showing the relations. Isthmus and lobes of thyroid gland.
Yes.
So this is
trachea.
And this is esophagus. And these are, you can see the muscles. These are the muscles, sternocleidomastoid, sternohyoid, sternothyroid muscles, and Yeah, this is carotid sheath. This is internal ulnar vein, artery, and venous nerve. So this is posterior surface, and this is the medial surface. We have ulnars. We have recurrent laryngeal nerve, external laryngeal nerve.
Victor, the surfaces, can you show us?
Surfaces. Surfaces. Where, in this picture?
Yes.
This is lateral surface. This is isthmus. Okay? Lobe is from here to here. This is lobe. This is lateral surface. Okay? And this is posterior surface. And this is medial surface.
Other people.
Now, why thyroid gland moves on because thyroid gland is enclosed in pretracheal fascia, and pretracheal fascia is attached on the cricoid cartilage and thyroid cartilage. Pretracheal fascia is attached on the laryngeal cartilages, that is cricoid and thyroid cartilages. So when you swallow, during swallowing, there is a swallowing reflex, the trachea and the larynx moves up. During swallowing reflex, the larynx moves up. Because to the larynx, what is larynx? Larynx is laryngeal cartilages.
Yes.
So larynx, when the larynx moves up, because to the laryngeal cartilages, thyroid gland is attached to it through the pretracheal fascia. So when the unswallowing, when the larynx moves up, thyroid gland moves up. This is the main reason why the thyroid gland moves unswallowing. There is another reason, that thyroid gland isthmus is adherent to the tracheal rings through the pretracheal fascia. But the main reason is that these thyroid gland is attached through the pretracheal fascia to the cartilages of the larynx. So this, and that's why when any patient comes to you with swallowing in front of neck, so how to differentiate it is thyroid or extra thyroid?
Swallow.
Ask the patient to swallow. If on swallowing this swelling moves, it means it is thyroid. If it doesn't move, it means it is not thyroid. Some other tissue.
Other cable.
What is pyramidal lobe? Not always, not in every thyroid gland. In some cases, there is a lobe here that projects from the upper border of the thyroid gland upwards. This is pyramidal in shape or conical in shape, and its upward attachment is to the hyoid bone or to the base of the tongue. So this accessory lobe is called the pyramidal lobe. So pyramidal lobe is not always present. When present, it extends from the upper border of thyroid cartilage, and it may extend to hyoid bone or to base of the tongue. And this lobe is called the pyramidal lobe. Sometimes muscular tissue is present in the pyramidal lobe. If muscular tissue is present in the pyramidal lobe, that muscle is called levator glandular thyroidy. Yes.
Is there any complication or manifestation of this? Or it's normal?
So what is levator glandular thyroidy? Levator glandular thyroid is a muscular tissue present in pyramidal lobe. Yes.
Pyramidal lobe, is it a remnant from the development during the same day?
Yes.
It is a normal variant, you can say. You know how the thyroid gland develops? Thyroid gland develops from the endoderm, you know, when the primordial pharynx, you know, their pharyngeal gut, we have how to develop pharyngeal gut, foregut, mid and high gut. In the pharyngeal gut, there is primordial pharynx. So in the from the primordial pharynx, there is overgrowth of some endodermal cells from the primordial pharynx, and then these overgrowth of cells, they descend downward in the neck and form the thyroglossal duct. Thyroglossal duct disappears, that this cells from the most distal part of the thyroglossal duct, they grow and they form bilobed structure, they form the thyroid gland, and rest of the thyroid gland become disappears. What are the embryological anomalies of the thyroglossal duct? Sometimes the thyroglossal duct or part of thyroglossal duct may persist. And sometimes thyroglossal fistula is formed. Sometimes sinus is formed. And sometimes accessory thyroid tissue or ectopic thyroid gland may be formed in the tongue, in the pharynx, near the hyoid bone, or even in the media, superior mediastinum, behind the manubrium sternae. So these are the anomalies of developmental anomalies, but pyramidal lobe is a normal variant. Accessory thyroid gland or ectopic thyroid gland can be found near the hyoid bone, in the tongue, in the superior mediastinum, or anyway along the path of descent of thyroid gland, that is thyroglossal duct. Lingual thyroid is, you know, it's common problem. In lingual thyroid gland, sometimes, you know, it grows and it, you know, results in problem, swallowing problem. And when you have to remove the thyroid gland, you have to, also lingual thyroid and thyroid, you have to make ultrasound and scanning of the thyroid tissue, maybe assess thyroid tissue here and there.
Other cable.
Yes.
Other cable.
What is the arterial supply? In thyroid gland, arterial supply is very important. Why important? Because the thyroid gland arterial supply, thyroid gland is richly supplied. If you compare the weight of the thyroid gland, so thyroid gland, the organ where richly supplied, you know, richest supply of the tissue in the body is carotid sinus, carotid body, aortic sinus, aortic body? Yes, very good. You know, baroreceptor, chemoreceptors. And thyroid gland also have very rich blood supply. From where the blood supply comes from thyroid gland? It must come from the external carotid artery. Okay? It must come from
subclavian
artery. You know, what is the first branch of, what is the first branch of external carotid artery? That is superior thyroid artery. Superior thyroid artery is the first branch of external carotid artery. And inferior thyroid artery comes from thyrocervical trunk. And thyrocervical trunk is a branch of subclavian artery. And subclavian artery is a branch of brachiocephalic trunk or arch of aorta. So from the subclavian artery, thyrocervical trunk gives inferior thyroid artery. And in small percentage of people, there is third artery, that is thyroid ema artery. If thyroid ema artery is present, it may come from brachiocephalic trunk, it may come from the arch of aorta, it may come from the common carotid artery, but it's sometimes present. So there are two arteries supplying the thyroid gland, that superior thyroid artery and inferior thyroid artery, coming from external carotid artery and thyrocervical branch of subclavian artery. And sometimes, if thyroid ema artery is present, it may come from the brachiocephalic or from the arch of aorta or from common carotid artery. Now, what is the important in arterial supply of the thyroid gland? You know, with the inferior thyroid artery runs the recurrent laryngeal nerve. And with the superior thyroid artery runs the external laryngeal nerve. So external laryngeal nerve, of course, with the superior thyroid artery and external laryngeal nerve and superior thyroid artery very close to each other till the upper pole of the thyroid gland. They become separate very near to the upper pole of the thyroid gland. So during thyroidectomy, superior thyroid artery must be ligated. So if you ligate the superior thyroid artery, it must be ligated very near to the thyroid pole. Why? To avoid injury to the external laryngeal nerve. But becomes separate at the upper pole of the gland. So during thyroidectomy, the superior thyroid artery must be ligated very near, close to the upper pole of the gland to avoid injury to the external gland. Okay. Now, what about inferior thyroid artery? inferior thyroid artery become closely related to the recurrent laryngeal nerve at the lower pole of thyroid gland. So inferior thyroid artery, no need to ligate the inferior thyroid artery in thyroidectomy. But if sometimes we have to ligate the inferior thyroid artery, this must be ligated after giving the branches to the parathyroid glands, because the parathyroid glands are supplied by the inferior thyroid artery. And inferior thyroid artery runs with the recurrent laryngeal nerve in the groove between the trachea and esophagus. So it must be ligated away from the lower pole of the thyroid gland. And second thing, recurrent laryngeal nerve runs behind the peritracheal fascia. So to avoid injury to the recurrent laryngeal nerve, you ligate the inferior thyroid artery away from the gland. And if peritracheal fascia is intact, it means that recurrent laryngeal nerve is intact, is safe. Because if recurrent laryngeal nerve is cut, what will happen? Change in voice, because laryngeal muscles all are supplied by the recurrent laryngeal nerve except one. What is that muscle? Cricothyroid. That is supplied by the external laryngeal branch of superior laryngeal nerve. And you know, all the many muscles of the larynx, they are adductor of the vocal cords. Only one muscle is abductor of the vocal cords. What is that muscle? That is the most important muscle in the body. Only one muscle and that is abductor. Yes, that is abductor of the vocal cord. That is posterior cricoarytenoid. Very good. Posterior cricoarytenoid. The most important muscle in the body. Then after that, diaphragm and heart muscle. Okay. What is the venous drainage?
Why?
Okay. Why? Larynx. Why larynx? You know vocal cords. Vocal cords are called sautia,
yeah.
Vocal folds. Vocal cords are like this. Vocal cords, their movement are abduction, adduction, and relaxation and tense. They become tense and opening and closing of any epiglottic fold. That is the laryngeal inlet. So this, okay. This is abduction of vocal cords, and this is adduction of vocal cords. So this is abduction. This is adduction.
Again, please.
Abduction is this.
No.
Adduction is this. This is abduction. This is adduction. So what is the job of larynx? Number one,
air
passage, and very important job is phonation, production of sound,
voice.
and sound. Coughing and weightlifting, all this. But two very important actions, production of sound, that is phonation and breathing. So production of sound is by movement of the vocal cords. The vocal cords, many muscles, they abduct vocal cords. Only one muscle is that, many muscles they adduct vocal cords, only one muscle that is abductor of vocal cord, that is posterior cricoarytenoid. If there is bilateral
blockage,
bilateral paralysis of bilateral
abductors
by injury to the
posterior abductor,
this muscle
blockage,
they will be
abducted.
Then the inlet will be closed. And no air passage will occur. So this is, we are talking about this. Okay. What is the venous drainage of the thyroid gland? Venous drainage, there are two arteries, remember. Superior thyroid artery and middle thyroid and inferior thyroid artery. But there are three veins. Superior thyroid vein, middle thyroid vein, and inferior thyroid vein. Superior and middle thyroid vein must drain in internal jugular vein. An inferior thyroid vein must drain in brachiocephalic vein. Okay? So there are two arteries and three veins. Two arteries are superior thyroid, inferior thyroid. From external coronary, from thyroid. There are three veins, superior thyroid, inferior thyroid, superior thyroid, middle thyroid in internal jugular. And inferior thyroid in
brachiocephalic.
So this is. Which artery is this? This is external carotid. This is superior thyroid artery. With the superior thyroid artery, can you see this yellow color?
Yes.
This is which nerve is this?
The color.
No.
When?
No.
External laryngeal nerve. And you know this is arch of Fiota. and this is subclavian, and this is thyrocervical trunk, and this is inferior thyroid. With the inferior thyroid, you can see this is, which nerve is this?
Recurrent.
Recurrent laryngeal nerve.
Again?
Veins, again.
Okay.
This is superior thyroid artery. Mm-hmm. It's coming from?
Carotid.
You know, external carotid artery ends at the level of upper border of thyroid cartilage by dividing into superficial, temporal and maxillary. There are 8 branches of the external carotid artery. First branch is superior thyroid. Superior thyroid artery is coming here and it is, its course with, which nerve is this?
External laryngeal.
This is external laryngeal nerve. It is coming, both artery and nerve are coming very close till they reach to the upper pole of the thyroid. Mm-hmm. So if you like it here or here or here, external carotid artery, there chances that you will also like it the external laryngeal nerve. So you have to like it this very close to the upper pole. Now here you can see this is thyrocervical trunk and this is inferior thyroid artery going here. So inferior thyroid artery runs with recurrent laryngeal nerve, but they become separate away from the lower pole. So you can like it and away from the lower pole. From veins, this is internal jugular vein, okay, and this is subclavian. So this vein, superior thyroid vein is coming in this, middle thyroid vein is going in this,
inferior.
And third vein is middle thyroid, and this is
inferior
thyroid from brachiocephalus. So superior thyroid vein and middle thyroid vein, they are going in internal jugular, and inferior thyroid in brachiocephalus. What is lymphatic drainage? Mainly in these cervical nodes.
No,
some lymph from pre-laryngeal, pre-tracheal and paratracheal lymph nodes. Okay. Now any question about thyroid gland?
Prothyroid.
Parathyroid. Easy, nothing. Parathyroid gland are 4 in number. Where they are located? They are located behind the thyroid gland. Behind. There are four superior parathyroid gland and inferior parathyroid gland. They are brownish yellow in color. And if you talk about the superior parathyroid gland, is both constant in position, lying within the thyroid pre-tracheal fascia and the middle of back of the thyroid node. It is located at the middle of back of the thyroid node, level with the first tracheal ring and above the inferior thyroid artery. Inferior parathyroid gland is located, it is less constant. Its position is variable. It is also within the pre-tracheal fascial capsule, behind the lower pole here, and not necessarily at the same level. Superior parathyroid gland develops from where?
Superior.
From fourth pharyngeal pouch.
Mm.
And yes. Inferior parathyroid gland develops from third pharyngeal pouch.
Okay.
You know about the pharyngeal arches, pouches and clefts? No, very well.
Yes.
And they share with
it?
No. Really? Pharyngeal pouches, pharyngeal arches, pharyngeal clefts?
No.
Heard of them?
Are located inside the ventricular
Capsule.
32 33 34 35 36 37 38 41 42 43 44
This is thyroid gland. These are the lobes, right, left. In this pyramidal lobe. This pyramidal lobe extends to hyoid bone. It may extend to base of the tongue. Mm. Okay. This is upper pole. This is lower pole. Upper pole extends to this is thyroid cartilage oblique line.
First ring.
And lower, the upper pole is projecting more upwards. Lower pole is not. It extends to sixth tracheal ring here.
The sixth
tracheal ring. If you see the relations.
So, see here,
these are parathyroid glands. Superior parathyroid glands and inferior parathyroid glands. Okay. Now, this is the lobe, left, right lobe of the thyroid gland. This is part of the isthmus and these are the lobes. You know, its medial relation is this. What is this? Trachea and larynx. Trachea and larynx comes in medial relation, and behind them is esophagus and pharynx. Laterally, here, strap muscles will come here. Anything else in that model? Anything? It means nothing in this model. The same thyroid gland. This is the part of isthmus here. This is the lobe. Upper pole extend to oblique line of thyroid cartilage. lower pole to sixth tracheal ring. This is related to second, third, and fourth rings of trachea. And this is the other muscles. Here. The same.
There's you know here muscles.
Yes.
Muscles.
Muscles.
Yeah.
These muscles of larynx.
No, this is
posterior.
Lateral.
No, in thyroid gland. If thyroid gland, if you know that the medial surface is related to larynx and trachea, it's enough. And pharynx and esophagus and two nerves enough. More than enough. Okay?
Yeah.
Now what's your question?
I said there is no model which can be description of the anterior lateral surface.
Huh? Anterior, I guess. There is a model.
What is it?
Uh-huh. Come on here.
Mm.
Come on there.
Doctor.
We are crossing the anterior laterally.
Sternohyoid?
Yes, this is. Sternohyoid.
Yeah.
And sternohyoid. This.
Yeah.
And sternothyroid is here.
What?
This is sternothyroid. Sternohyoid. So this is the related.
What is that? This one bigger. This one bigger.
Yeah. This is sternocleidomastoid, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And you know, this is thyroid lobe. So this muscle is coming from sternum to hyoid bone. This is sternohyoid.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And sternothyroid muscle must come here, but not shown in this. Must be here. Maybe here. So these are the muscles, sternohyoid, sternothyroid here. And also sternocleidomastoid. It but it's little away, but you can see.
Okay, thank you.
Sternocleidomastoid.
Thank you.
Thank you. Any questions? Any questions?